ordinance, once again, we are looking at this word in Deuteronomy in Deuteronomy 12:3. Ye shall utterly destroy all the places where nations which ye shall possess serve their gods, upon the high mountains and upon the hills and under every green tree. In verse 3, and ye shall overthrow their altars and break down the pillars and burn their groves with fire. So can you burn a grove underneath a grove? So this word here is not just groves as it is translated here, but it is Asherah, which is the Assyrian, the Asherite. Because you shall overthrow their altars and break down their pillars and burn their groves with fire. And you shall hew down the graven images of their gods and destroy the names of them out of their places. Yahweh was not happy with the worship of the Asherah under the other trees, or alongside of them, or as they were themselves. Also, we have this word in Deuteronomy 16:21. We'll start with verse 20. That which is altogether just shalt thou follow, that thou mayest live and inherit the land which Yahweh the Elohim giveth thee. And then in verse 21, thou shalt not plant thee a grove of any tree near unto the altar of Yahweh thy Elohim, which thou shalt make thee. He says, shall thou set thee up any image which Yahweh the Elohim hateth. So he hates this. He absolutely hated it. So let's go back now into Ezekiel for a moment. Behold, the Assyrian, the Asherah, was a cedar in Lebanon with fair branches and with a shadowing shroud, foliage a shroud, and in high stature, and his top was among the thick boughs. Verse 4 in Ezekiel 31. The waters made him great, the deep set him up on high, and the rivers running round about his plants, and set out the little rivers into all the trees of the field. The words for waters here are not your general rivers. These were actually kind of man-made water flow agents, like canals that humans built generally, like from the Nile. therefore its height was exalted, in verse 5, therefore his height, the Asherah, was exalted above all the trees of the field, and his boughs were multiplied, and his branches became long because of the multitude of the waters when he shot forth. Branches, the Hebrew text read branch, singular, singularly like here in Ezekiel. His boughs are its arms, and the foliage of heaven made their nests in the boughs and the arms under the branches. Did all the beasts of the field bring forth their young, and under his shadow dwelt all great nations. All of the great nations were under this one tree. Thus was he fair in his greatness, in the length of his branches, for his root was by great waters. So when something like this falls, that it covers all of the nation, people say, yeah, I can kind of see these messes, these great messes we have as being cut off trees. That looks fairly obvious, like a a rock. Something is turned to rock, supposedly. Tree is turned to rock. But as the scientists say, but how would we get these hills and valleys and such like that? Well, if we've got these branches that reach to all nations, these branches come down with the trees, what would they look like?